So now we have some of the accessories that are used in surveying, that is chaining and in ranging. So we'll go through them in a very brief manner, and then we will proceed on with the next subject, with the next topic. So here we have a ranging rod, and this is about 20 centimeter red in color, then 20 centimeter white in color, and it is about 2 meter in length. And the other type of rod is black and white. It is about 20 centimeter black and 20 centimeter white over here. So this is all about a ranging rod. And coming to the pegs, it is about 15 centimeter or 150 mm in height, and the square section is about 25 by 25 mm or 1 inch by 1 inch. And right over here is shown the position of drawing the peg in the ground. It is in a slanted position, and this is a wrong practice, and this is the right position. For more accuracy purposes, we can place a nail right in the center of this peg over here, so you get a smaller point. So that is one of the reason that we can provide a nail right on top of this wooden peg. Here in the next figure, view of the peg is shown over here, and it can be also about 3 centimeter, and this is the position right towards the right of our screens, which is being showing that is being pierced into the ground. So this is pegs over here. Next over here are the arrows, and this arrow over here is about 400 mm of m plus minus 5 mm in height, and it is made out of mild steel wire, which is about 4 to 6 mm in diameter. So this is a brief intro about some of the parts that we are going to use, and now we come to the ranging part directly. This is the normal adopted procedure of ranging in the field. If you look at this person, he is right sticking next to this rod. He is in a very close position, and the position that you require to be in line is this location. That is the point that has been right inside the ground. The rod can be vertical, it can be drifting towards either of the sides, but this particular location is fixed on the grounds. And I'll just come with the right position, and this is a wrong tendency of ranging. The procedure that has to be adopted here in the video, as you can see, I have tried to explain you the right position of ranging. You can see over here that there is a ranging rod A over here and a ranging rod B over here. Now, if your distance is 3 to 5 meters and you are able to watch these edges, that is the point that has been inserted in the ground, then your ranging will be accurate. And if not, then you have to get down and take a better position that is more than 3 to 5 meters, and then range your line. So this is a practical aspect, and you have to keep this in mind whenever I talk about the word ranging. So now, as you can see, that in this figure, I have tried to explain in quite detail the procedure of rating, ranging in different positions. When you are at this position, then your ranging line is this. And when you change your position and you bend a bit and you move more behind, your position comes up to be this way. And finally, this is the best position that you can adopt for ranging. So whenever I talk about ranging, it means that I am talking about this point, the third position of ranging over here. And this is how the ranging has to be done. And this is the line that we need to range. So we'll select a point A somewhere here and a point B somewhere here in such a way that from A, B is accessible and we can see it clearly without any obstacles in between. Now what we do is we put a ranging rod right onto this A point like this. So here I place this ranging rod at the point A, and we have placed a ranging rod at point B now. So we'll keep ourselves in quite a comfortable position, and as shown in the figure over here, select the rods which we are seeing or which we are ranging over here. So this is the procedure of putting now two rods. So from here we position ourselves and we look at these two ranging rods and point A and point B. Now what we need over here is a third ranging rod. Without the third ranging rod, our chaining is not going to be complete. You can keep this ranging rod in any location in such a way that this line is absolutely straight. So this is our ranging line and this has to be absolutely straight so that our ranging is complete. So we'll put a third ranging rod right in between A and B, and this rod will be called C in order to make it a straight line or a 180 degree line. So here we have the third ranging rod and this makes our line absolutely ranged. So this is how we go with ranging with three rods minimum. So this is the method which shows you that how you need to position yourself while ranging, and when your ranging is accurate, then your chaining and all the readings will be absolutely accurate. So I hope I have made my point clear. If there are any queries, any questions, you can write to me or you can comment and I'll try to clarify that point. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching my video.